Hi, my name is Akar Patel. I work with Amnesty in India. 2 years ago, we were accused of sedition. The media was absolutely convinced we had done something wrong. There were mobs outside the office here. There were talk shows that were on this subject many nights running. This was 2 years ago. What happened in that time? The police investigated this after the case was filed, found there was no evidence to support anything that was said in the media. Everything that had been said against Amnesty actually turned out to be false. That case has gone nowhere. The police have told the court to drop it. That is the status from that period, if you should have remembered it. Today, we are facing fire for something else. We've been told we've done something wrong. What exactly we've done wrong is, I actually don't know, because there is no complaint against us. There is no FIR against us. We've had visits from government agencies that we have fully cooperated with. Most of what they took from us is documents that are already in the public domain. There was no reason for them to have visited us. We could have handed them over to them. Had they asked, had they been to our website, they would have seen that much of the material that we have been asked for is already on the website and has been there for many years. But we will continue to cooperate with them in every possible way. We would like you to consider this, that without any formal accusation against us, we ought not to be vilified either in the media or by the government or through leaks. If there is something that the government should find wrong, and it is something that it files a complaint or an FIR against us for, we will obviously fight it in court. That stage has not yet come. At the moment, we stand accused of absolutely nothing. We have been in India off and on for 50 years. We have been associated with such people as George Fernandez, who was a member of Amnesty in India, as Lal Krishna Advani, for whom we fought globally when he was jailed during the emergency. We have over 45 lakh Indians who've taken some action in support of our work. We have about 1 lakh people who have contributed money to our work. This is an organization that for decades has worked for constitutional rights in India and has upheld the fabulous values that all of us hold so dear. Yes, it is true that much of our work might be seen by some people as not being particularly the kind of thing that a rights organization should be doing. I know that. I know that there are many people who believe that we ought not to be doing work on constitutional rights in Jammu and Kashmir. But we believe that constitutional rights are guaranteed to every Indian citizen, no matter who they are, no matter where they come from. This is the ethos. This is our fundamental belief. We want to be in an India where things that are not palatable to many people can be said. The alternative is an India where things that are not palatable cannot be said. None of us wants that kind of India. We support constitutional values, have always done so. We would ask our supporters to continue to stand behind us.